Good morning, and welcome to the Great Tower in Dover, one of the many properties owned by His Grace King Henry II. The castle's been around for a very long time, since the time of the first Norman king, William the Conqueror. King Henry II isn't a Norman, though. He's an Angevin. The Angevin Empire came immediately after the Norman Empire. The king is due for a visit any day now, so I'm ensuring everything is ship-shape. But I have some time before I need to continue with my day's work, so I'm happy to answer any questions you may have. Who's first?
Hi, I'm Alicia, and I'm 8 years old.
Hello, Alicia. What's your question?
What changes did King Henry II make to Dover?
King Henry decided to turn Dover into the most advanced castle design in Europe, including the Inner Bailey, towers, and the Great Tower. This means Dover is widely admired by many of the king's most important visitors.
Thank you, Steward. Goodbye.
Thank you for your question, Alicia. It looks like we have someone else joining us.
Hello, my name's Francesca.
Hello, Francesca. What would you like to know?
What's a steward and what do you do?
Well, as the Lord Steward, I was appointed by the king to oversee every arrangement to prepare for his arrival, be that making sure the larder is fully stocked or that the hall is ready to receive guests. It's a very important role, with a lot of responsibility. I answer only to the king.
Thank you, Steward. Goodbye.
You are most welcome. Now, we have another two people joining us. Hello, who are you?
Hi, I'm Brendan, and I'm 10 years old.
I'm Callum, I'm 13 years old.
Hello, boys. What would you like to know?
Why did the Normans build Dover Castle?
Well, the Strait of Dover is the shortest sea crossing between Dover and Europe, so it is important to defend it against invaders. It's also the shortest sea crossing between England and Normandy in northern France.
Where does the king sleep?
The king sleeps in his private chamber, with only the most important people allowed inside. But the Chamberlain allows me to go in whenever I need to. Follow me inside, I'll show you. We are now in the most important room in the tower, the King's Chamber. He works here, takes his leisure here with a chosen few, and sleeps here. Fine fabrics and furniture made by the best artisans in Europe. A residence fit for a king, eh, boys?
Yeah, definitely. Thanks, Lord Steward.
Goodbye, boys. Now, who's this?
Hello, I'm Felicity.
Hello, Felicity. What would you like to ask?
Where does the king keep all of his wealth at Dover Castle?
The king travels constantly. Many of his precious possessions travel with him too. Some of his very valuable possessions are here already. This is the king's wardrobe for his precious possessions and money. Next door, there's a privy, a private toilet for the king. Thank you for your question. Now, who are you two?
Hi, I'm George.
And I'm Hal.
What would you like to know?
What does the king have for breakfast?
Concerned with your stomachs, are we? Well, follow me down to the kitchens. We're now at the very bottom of the Great Tower, which we use for storage and sometimes as a temporary kitchen. There's a large kitchen outside in the bay for most people, but this is the King's own private kitchen, which we set up specially for these visits. As for breakfast, the king eats whenever he chooses and whatever he chooses. When he wakes, perhaps he may call for a simple dish of bread dipped in wine. Or another time he may request a whole rabbit, a true luxury, even for those well paid such as myself.
Thank you, Steward. Goodbye.
Now, I really must get on and get to the Great Hall, so if you have any other questions, I'll have to answer them upstairs. Now, I have time for one more question before I need to return to my duties. You, come forward. Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Rosie.
Hello, Rosie. What would you like to know?
What do you do for fun when you're not working?
Well, there isn't much free time when we're waiting for the King's arrival or if he's in attendance, as there's always something to organise. There are some games that servants like to play, though. Servant boys often play with small animal bones, knuckle bones, and they also cut board games into the kitchen tables to play Nine Man's Morris or Tic-Tac-Toe. I wouldn't normally allow it, but if they've done their day's work, then I'll turn a blind eye. As for nobles such as our king, chess is a preferred game, as is tables or backgammon. And then there's checkers or draughts. Perhaps you know these games.
Wow, thanks so much, Stuart.
Right, that's enough for today. I really must return to my duties. Goodbye.